Hi everyone, welcome you all. This is Pawan from SDT channel. In this video, we will see how to work with object-oriented programming features in JavaScript. So basically, object-oriented programming means we support certain features like class, object, inheritance, polymorphism. All these concepts will be supported by a language, and that language is called as an object-oriented programming language. So JavaScript is also supported these features. Now we'll discuss the features in multiple videos. So especially in this video, I'll focus on class and object. So first of all, let us start with the class and object. What is class? A class is a logical entity which contains variables and methods. So if you see the real-time objects, like real-time example, suppose I have a class which contains the students, number of students, and every student is having some data like his roll number, name, grade, marks, and everything, right? So I will create a class and where I will specify certain number of variables and methods, and based on the class I can define multiple objects. What does that mean is a class is a logical entity, whereas object is a physical entity. So we can create multiple objects for one class. If I take an animal as an example, so animal is basically a class, and all these animals like elephant, giraffe, these are all comes under the objects, and these are physical. Why I'm saying all these objects are belongs to one class? Because all of them is having a similar kind of attributes and behavior. So all of them are objects. They are comes under one class. So in technically, a class is a collection of variables and methods, and we can define multiple objects based upon one class. In other words, we can say a class is a logical entity, whereas object is a physical entity. And class doesn't occupy any space in the memory, because it is a logical entity, whereas an object will occupy a certain amount of space in the memory because these are physical. Now we'll see the definition. A class is a logical entity which contains the variables and method, whereas object is a physical entity and it is an instance of a class. We can create any number of objects for one class. And normally, normally class contains the methods, right? So method is nothing but it is just like a function, and which contains certain number of statements which will perform certain logic. So the same function, if I create within the class, we can just call it as a method. So if I create a function outside of the class, we can just call it as a function. And the same function, if I create inside the class, we can call it as a method. So what method contains means it contains a certain number of statements. And sometimes methods can also accept some arguments, just like a functions. And the class also contains the constructors. So constructor is also like a method. So we will discuss that, what is constructor later. And first of all, we'll see what is class and object and method. And then we will discuss what about the constructor. So now go to Visual Studio Editor and Visual Studio Code Editor. Here I will show you how to create a class. And then we will see how to create multiple objects. And through object, we can access all the class variables and methods. Now we'll see how we can do that. So let me just go to Visual Studio Code Editor, and I'm just creating a new class, new JavaScript file. I will name it as classes.js. Now I created a new JavaScript file. So how to create a class? In JavaScript, to create a class, we have to use a keyword called class. Class is my keyword. Class, and I'm just creating a student class. Name of the class is student. And starting curly brace and ending curly brace. So inside this, we can define the variables and methods. So normally variables also can be defined within the method in JavaScript. So let me just create one method here. So student is having some data like student ID, name, grade, marks, and so on, right? I'm just creating, I'm just adding some data to the student class. How we can do that? We have to create a method. So let me just create one method called setDetails. So this is a method I'm creating. And inside this method, I will add some data to the student class. Like SID I want to add, SID equal to something 101. And then I'll say SName equal to, let's say, John. He's a name, it's John. He's the name of the student. And I want to save grade. So let's say grade equal to, let's say, EA. So now I have defined three different variables. So currently, these variables all belong to the method. So these are all local variables. Now, if I want to make these variables or belongs to the class, we have to use one keyword called this keyword. It's a this representing a class. So this is always representing class, this dot SID, this dot SName, this dot grade. So now these variables are belongs to the class. Now I have also created variables within the method, set details. Now I'll create another method by which I can print the data of the student. So I will create one more method, let's say display. And inside this method, I will just print the data. Let's say console.log. And here I'm printing. How to access this variable? Again, this.sid, this is always representing the class. Okay, this.sid, and this.sname, and this.grade. So I can access those variables like this, right? Now, here I have written one statement, console.log, and here I'm printing sid, sname, and grade. Now I have a student class which contains two methods. Now, first method is having data, and the second method is responsible for just printing the data. Now, so this is a logical entity, right? So once you have, if you want to use this class, we need to create an object. So how to create an object? In JavaScript, to create an object, we have to first create a variable. So let's say stu, which is an object variable, equal to new student. So this is how we need to create an object. So once you create an object stu, through this object, I can access setDetails method. And what this method will do, this will call and assign the values into the variables. And then stu dot, I'm calling display method. So this particular method will display the values of these variables. Now let us execute this. So how to execute this class? We can just go to the terminal, open the new terminal. And here I can write a command called node classes.js. Now it is printed the data here. So this is how we can create a methods in the class, and we can create an object of the class, and we can access those methods through the object. Now, so here, if I see here, this is a method I created, right? So inside this method itself, I have assigned some data. Sometimes we can also pass the data to this particular method. Sometimes we can also pass this data as an arguments to this method. So how we can do this? So instead of hard coding this data, what I can do is I will just define some variable. Let's say ID, or I can say SID, sname, grade. So I can use same variables or different variables. So that can SID, sname, grade are related to class. They are class variables because I am representing those by using this keyword. So this is always representing the class. So I'm just passing three, I'm accepting three values here. So whenever I calling this method, I need to pass three values. Now I'm passing from here, 101, and I'll say John, right? So comma and grade I'm passing, let's say A. So I'm passing three arguments into this particular method. And now this method will receive these values into these three arguments. Now what I should do is I need to assign the values. SID should be assigned to this SID. And this SID is an argument variable. And this one belongs to the class. Now similarly, sname should be specified here. And grade should be specified here. Right? So now you can also use different names here. You can also use a different name. Suppose you can, instead of SID, I can use just ID, and you can assign the ID like this. Perfectly fine. So if you want to use the same variable, you can still use it. Because how this method will differentiate means by using this keyword. So when I say this.sid, this variable belongs to the class. And ID belongs to the method. So that's how this method will differentiate. So now I have passed the arguments from when I calling this method, and this method is receiving those arguments, receiving that values into those variables. And now again, internally, I'm assigning the values to this variables. And now I'm just calling the display method. Now observe this, save it, and I'm running this code. So every time when you run my script, I'm just opening the terminal, a new terminal, and here I'm running node, right? So every time I'm doing this manually, so node, let's say classes.js I'm running, right? So it is giving some error. Let me write one more time. So I'm saying SID, and here ID I mentioned. Just let's correct it, save it. Okay, now let me just execute this once again. Observe this carefully. I'm just opening my terminal and go to terminal window, and here I'm running this command, node, then classes.js. Now it is giving a data, right? This is how we can create a method, and which is also can accept the arguments. So when you run your JavaScript file, so far how we have run is, we have opened the terminal, And here every time I'm just writing the command manually, right? So instead of this, we can add one extension and by which we can directly run your script. So without typing any command here. So we have certain extensions are there. So one of the extension is code runner. So let me show you how we can install that extension and then how we can run your script. So just go to settings here and you can see here extensions. You can also look at here in this particular window, go to settings and you can find something called extensions and go here and select code runner and just type code runner here. Search for code runner. Code runner. This is the best, it's a good extension which is available for Visual Studio Code. And what is this one is, this extension is basically used to run your script. And click on install code runner and I've just installed. Okay, so once you have installed this code runner, then you can close it. And you can also close this one. And once you install this your code runner, you will get a new option like this, run code option here, right? And by which we can directly run your script. And there is one more arrow mark here, you will get it here. You can also run your script by using this arrow mark. So this is a shortcut way. So every time instead of writing this command to run your JavaScript file, you can just add one extension called code runner extension, okay? Now I'm just running this script by clicking on this icon, run code, then your program is executed. So running your program and here you can see the output. This is the output you are seeing. And where you can see this output in the output tab, in the same terminal. So in the terminal, new terminal, you have to open here. There are problems, output, debug console, terminal. There are multiple options are there. So instead of seeing output in the terminal, you can see output window here. You can see the output. Okay, the same command is also ran. So node and location of your JavaScript file. So this is another way to run your JavaScript file. Now, so here we have just created one student class which contains a method and two methods I created. And first method will accept the data and fill the data into class variables. Then through the object, I created one object and through the object, I'm calling the setDetails method and which will, and these parameters will go and assign into the class variables. And then I'm calling the display method and which will print the data of the student. Now here, instead of creating the method, why we are using this method basically is this method will initialize the data into the variables. That's the main purpose. And when you create this method, we need to call this method explicitly through object, right? So instead of creation of this method, we can also create a constructor. So constructor is there. So what is constructor? Constructor is also just like a method. But the difference is the constructor will be used only for initializing the data. Only for initializing the data. And the constructor also can take the arguments. But constructor is only meant for initializing the data. That's one thing. The other thing is, whenever I create an object, constructor will automatically invoke. So we no need to call the constructor by using the object name. Not like a method. So constructor will automatically invoke at the time of object creation. Now, instead of this method, I will create one constructor. Let me just comment this. Now, how to create a constructor? So exactly the same way we have to create a constructor, but we have to use one keyword called constructor. Instead of giving the method name, I simply say constructor. This is a keyword. This is the only change. Constructor is a keyword. And constructor also can take the arguments into these variables and SID will assign to the SID. S name is assigned to the name, grade is assigned to the grade. Now this constructor will automatically called at the time of object creation. So now I no need to call this method now. I can just comment this. So at the time of object creation, automatically this constructor will be invoked. But here this constructor is accepting some data, expecting some data. So we have to pass the data at the time of object creation. Now from here I'm passing 101 and name of the student I'm passing as a John and here I'm passing the grade. Okay, so this is the way we need to call the constructor. Let stu new student and student ID, name of the student and the grade of the student. So as soon as I created an object and this constructor will automatically invoked And then immediately I'm calling the display method. I have commented this setDetails method now. I don't need this method if you have a constructor, right? So now the same method I have replaced with the constructor. Now let us execute this and see how the constructor is behaving. So I'm not calling the constructor explicitly. At the time of object creation, constructor will automatically invoke. Now let me run this code by clicking this button so you can see the same data which is created. And this is a way we can replace a method with the constructor. But just observe this, methods are different than constructor. Method can be called explicitly and method performs certain logic. Method can do a complex operations. Method will take the arguments. And methods we can access through object only. Whereas constructor will automatically invoke at the time of object creation. Constructor will take the arguments, but constructor is only meant for initializing the values. At the time of object creation, constructor will be invoked. And one more thing here is, we can create any number of objects for one class. So here STU are created, right? So similarly, I can create STU1 and let's create STU2 and let's create STU3. So I can create any number of objects. And every time I'll change the value, let's say 2, say 3 and 4, he's a John, or I can say David. And this is another student, let's say David. And here he's John or he's Smith, right? So he's Mary. So like this, we can add data. Let's say A grade, he's a B grade, and he's C grade. So I can create any number of objects for a single class. Now, to display this data, we need to call the method which is belongs to specific object. So whenever I create a class, which is a, just a logical entry, we create any number of objects. But even though we created n number of objects, objects are independent. That's another thing which we need to remember. Here I have a student class. Student class I created. For this, I have created multiple objects. STU1, STU2, STU3. I have created multiple objects. So these objects are independent, even though they are derived from the same class. Every object is having their own individual memory, which is occupied. So the data, whichever we created methods and variables in the student class, and which are also belongs to STU1. So STU1 will have their own copy of the variables and methods. And student 2 is also having their own copy. Student 3 is also having their own copy of the methods and variables. Similarly, it is applicable for all the objects. Now, when I say student 1, when I call the constructor, this will invoke the student 1 constructor. When I say student 2, this will invoke student 2 object constructor. When I say student 3, STU3, which will invoke the STU3 object constructor. Similarly, we need to also call the methods from the respective objects. So we'll see how to call those methods from the respective objects. So as soon as I created the constructor, I'll say stu1.display, I need to call dot display. And this particular method will display the data. So this method I'm calling, spelling mistake is there. Let me just properly write. Right, so now I'm just calling the display method to display the data. And similarly here also, stu2.display I'm calling. And this display method is called from stu1 object. And this one is called from stu2 object. Now here stu3.display, so which is called from stu3 object. Now I created three different objects and I'm adding a different type of data in three students, and I'm also displaying the data about three students. Previously we created one more object, including this, totally four objects we created. Now save the file and let's run it. So now we can see that it is printed the data of totally four objects. Right, so this is how we need to work with classes, objects, methods, and also constructor. Right, a class is a logical entity, whereas object is a physical entity. For one class, we can create any number of objects, and a class contains the methods as well as constructor. And every object is independent. So whenever I initiate the constructor or call the methods, those methods or constructor will be invoked respective object from respective objects. So this is a concept of class, object, methods, and constructors, right? So now we also learn about constructor. So class also contains a constructor. Constructor will be called when you create an object for the class. So it will automatically invoke. But even if methods, we have to call explicitly. So there's a difference between method and a constructor, right? So that is all about class, object, methods, and constructor in JavaScript. So that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.